When you are aware of yourself, there is no object. What we see is not matter. That's not real. It's not really a thing or an object. What we see is consciousness. And the consciousness is real. Consciousness, empty of matter, is the truth. And the Maya does not disappear, but illusion disappears. Like seeing water in the desert. That's the illusion. That disappears. We know that it is not water, but still it is visible as water, so the illusion is gone, but the Maya is still there, seeing it as water. The only difference, we don't go running after water for helping our thirst away. What we do is see the Fata Morgana as it is and leave it. So illusion is gone, but the Maya is still there, the wrong vision, but we know it is wrong. There is no creation, and there is no created things like matter. There is just dimensionless awareness. It is modulating itself in all forms of experience. Our awareness is taking the form of the appearances, like water takes the form of the glass where it is in. And what you see is not the form, but your own empty self that has modulated in the experience that you see. So, in the first we lose ourselves to an experience. That means that we fall asleep. Awareness is not aware, and it feels or covers itself with its own creativity. And we are lost in the creation of our awareness. We are not aware of the awareness, but we are aware of the creation. And then that is what suffers. If it suffers enough, awareness has to come back to itself. That is the second step. We return from the creation objects to our self-awareness. And that is the process of prayer. The essence of prayer or self-inquiry, that it's returning to the I am. The awareness is now back in awareness. But still, there is a creation outside. It starts every morning when we come out of the deep sleep and we go into our daily consciousness. There is the creation. You cannot say it doesn't exist. But it doesn't exist as we think it is. First you have the experience that loses itself. The awareness loses itself in experience, and then when it suffers, the awareness turns to itself, and then experience outside loses itself in awareness. It loses its form that hurts. It doesn't make us more, anymore feeling that we are that what we experience. Instead of awareness going into experience, the experiences go back in awareness. So there is nothing really changed. There is still awareness and appearances. Experiencing things in the day, but we don't lose ourselves anymore. The first step, so, is we have lost in experiences, and as a result we suffer. The second step is turning away from the objects. I am not my thoughts, I am not my feelings, I am not my activities, I am not my relationships. This is returning back to what you really are, naked awareness. And then this returning again outside, and we face the objects of experience, but we don't lose ourselves in them any longer. They lose themselves, their forms, in us. We incorporate objective experience within our new understanding. So that is still everything as before, but it is now seen that it is a substance of our own awareness. Our own consciousness creates stuff, and this stuff is not really an object, it is just a form of consciousness. So it doesn't hurt anymore, because consciousness is in reality, it's no thing. It's not nothing, but it is no thing. That's what we've learned. So this makes so happy and relieved that we are just the freedom to enjoy whatever appears. Namaste. Thank you.
someone's on.